black dal. So what I have done is I have soaked the black urad dal overnight for 8 to 9 hours. Or if not, if you're planning this last minute, soak it for 5 to 6 hours and then put it in a hot case with hot water so the spearing is faster. So exactly as what I was telling you is I've taken only black dal and nothing else. Generally people take rajma or chana dal. Trust me, you don't need any of this. The classic way of preparing this dal makhani is with just your black dal, and it's going to be the whole dal and not the split dal.
In a pan, I'm going to take some butter. This recipe is only made in butter, guys. Don't try it out with oil or ghee. Trust me, the result with butter is something else. So once the butter is heated, I'm going to add some ginger garlic paste. For all the ingredients, don't forget to check out my description box, guys. Okay, we're going to cook this till you get a nice aroma. So this recipe is only on low flame, guys. Next, I'm adding in some red chili powder. It gives a brilliant color, guys. So definitely use this chili powder and nothing else. And right after this, I'm going to add my tomato puree. Generally at restaurant, they use the canned ones because it gives a better color. But I will show you today with just your tomato puree how you get exactly as the ones you get at restaurant. The color, the texture, everything. And then I'm adding some salt. Even though this is a blanched tomato puree, I'm still gonna let this tomato mixture cook on low flame around 15 to 20 minutes or till you see that the butter has been oozing on top. So this is a sign that your tomato has been cooked. Generally in this recipe, I believe less is more. So you don't have to work with too many ingredients, just with 4 or 5 ingredients you're good.
Tomato puree is done, guys. What next we're going to do is we're going to put the cooked dal to our tomato puree.
And once the tomato mixture is mixed with your dal, it is going to start taking in the shape. Exactly like how you get at the restaurant, super thick and luscious. And once we're done with this, the process of making this dal, a dal makhani is going to start. So we're going to start adding in some butter. So I'm just showing you generally how at restaurant they make, they add in a super high amount of butter to make it really thick and rich. But if you're making at home or if you're conscious about your fat content, definitely you can reduce the quantity. And moving on to another hack that I'm going to show you. So with this hand blender, I'm just going to blend everything together. So if you're putting in less butter, you can definitely try this, as this is going to thicken your dal even more. And once we're done with this, I'm going to let this cook on low flame for around 15 to 20 minutes. Okay, for the tempering part, I'm going to take 1 cube of butter. You can even do this with ghee, it doesn't matter, but for this I'm taking butter. Now let this become a little hot. And then adding in red chili powder. I have added around 1 teaspoon, guys, and if you want your dal to be spicy, then you can double the quantity. And within 2 or 3 seconds, turn off the gas so you don't let your red chili powder to burn. And And now the key ingredient of this dal is going to be lots of cream. So I'm going to go about with one good dollop of cream in my dal. And guys, remember this, as soon as you add in your cream, you got to turn off your gas and then mix in. Guys, in this festive season, I definitely think this dal is a super versatile dish, as this goes in perfectly with everything, be it your rotis, your parathas, even the churchur naan that I had made in my previous video. It goes super well with that. I'm leaving the link to the churchur naan. If you guys haven't watched it, do try this out. The combination is amazing. And our dal is ready, guys. I'm just gonna show you up close how the consistency is. You see how thick and rich it looks. We're just adding in little butter and cream. You'll have this amazing restaurant style dal ready for your festive season when you have your guests or your friends over. And for presentation, I'm just gonna drizzle some cream on top of it and garnish it with some coriander and a cube of butter, and that's it. Hope this video was super useful for you with all my hacks and tricks. Do try this out, and if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Until next time, bye.